Hey guys, in this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to use the source monitor inside Adobe Premiere Pro. Let's get started. The source monitor plays one video clip at a time, and its primary job is to help the editors prepare the video footage for editing. Source monitor contains both time ruler and controls for playback. The time code can be seen at the bottom left of the source monitor, which portrays the duration of the clip. This duration can vary from hours to frames per second. Besides the time code, we have a scaling tool for the source monitor. This scaling tool helps the editor to zoom in and zoom out of the video clips inside the source monitor. Scaling options are available from 10% up to 400%. We also have video only and audio only icons. If we only click and drag the video only icon, the video will be dragged to the timeline. And similarly, if we click and drag the audio only icon, then only the audio will be dragged to the timeline. Now let's discuss the playback resolution settings for the source monitor. Playback resolution settings allow the user to lower the resolution of the previews that Premiere Pro displays in the source monitor. Lower resolutions are easier to playback, so you can set playback resolution to a lower value. For example, 1/4 of the actual resolution for smooth playback. And set the pause resolution to full. In the description below, you can find a link to Novela Elements, which offers millions of incredible resources to assist you on your video creation journey. We also have a marker option on the bottom of the source panel, or you can simply press M on the keyboard. We can add multiple markers to our footage. Markers are often used when we need different portions of the same video clip. To remove markers, simply right-click on the time ruler and choose either clear marker to remove all markers or clear selected marker to remove only the selected markers. Then we have in point and out point icons, which add a pointer wherever the playhead is played on the timeline. Else you can simply add in and out points by using the keyboard shortcuts, that is I and O. In point and out point helps the editor to select a certain portion of the video clip before dragging it to the timeline. Besides in and out points, we have a go to in and go to out icon, which jumps to the in point of the clip and out point of the video clip. Or you can simply press Shift plus I for go to in and Shift plus O for go to out on the keyboard. Then we also have the option to move between frames, which is back one frame icon, and the forward one frame icon. These icons allow us to move frame by frame backwards and forwards. The keyboard shortcut for this is the left arrow and right arrow keys. Source monitor also has a play and pause button. This helps the editor to stop or start playing the footage as and when required. Besides this, source monitor also has an option of an insert icon, which helps us to insert a video clip exactly on the spot where the playhead is placed on the timeline. The shortcut for this is a comma symbol. Now let's move on to the overwrite icon, which overwrites the video clip exactly on the spot where the playhead is placed on the timeline. The shortcut for this is the full stop symbol. Next, we have the export frame icon, which can be used for exporting a single frame from the video clip. Place your playhead on the desired frame in the video clip. Click on the Export Frame button. A dialog box will be opened. Now enter a name for this frame and select the export format. You can also check the box if you want this frame to be imported into your project. Just click on OK and your frame will be exported. If you want to download project files or any of the assets used in creating this video, you can find the link in the description below. And that's it. In this tutorial, you've learned how to use the source monitor inside Adobe Premiere Pro. kindly share your experience in the comments section below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon in the next video tutorial.